an exciting time at NASA. We are building and testing the rocket that will enable a new era of human space exploration. The most powerful rocket ever built. America's deep space rocket, the Space Launch System. Welcome back to SLS Trivia. I'm Kevin O'Brien. I'm a driver and I'm a flyer. But most importantly, I'm your host. Today we've got three new questions about deep space. So let's get right to it. I've got a really good feeling about this. Question number one. Once SLS reaches low Earth orbit, what in-space propulsive maneuver will it perform to send its payload to the moon? Is it the lunar orbit orientation propulsion technique, translunar injection, or the holdo maneuver? Well, it takes a big rocket to get big payloads to the moon, and that's why the colossal SLS rocket will be the only rocket capable of launching crew and large cargo to the moon in a single launch. The holdo maneuver may be useful when protecting resistance transporters from attack from the First Order, but it won't do you much good in getting to the moon. Nope, there's no plot holes in this one. To get to the moon, SLS will perform a translunar injection to create enough velocity to overcome the pull of Earth's gravity. On its first flight, SLS will be capable of delivering more than 26 metric tons to TLI, and the evolved SLS Block 2 will be capable of delivering more than 45 metric tons to TLI, making SLS the world's most powerful rocket. Wow! On to Q2. Punch it! On Exploration Mission 1, the SLS rocket's interim cryogenic propulsion stage will give the Orion spacecraft the big in-space boost needed to fly to the moon and beyond. The ICPS will be powered by what engine? Is it the RL-10, the SRB-42, or a twin ion engine? When the ICPS fires to perform a translunar injection, what rocket engine will it be firing? Well, SRB-42 engines are helpful when trying to make the Kessel run in less than 12 parsecs, or fighting off TIE fighters, which happen to be powered by twin ion engines. But the ICPS will be powered by the liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen-fueled RL-10. The RL-10, which has been crucial to NASA's space exploration and has put hundreds of commercial and military payloads into orbit, will produce more than 24,000 pounds of thrust when performing a TLI. How are you doing so far? Great, kid! Don't get cocky! Question number three. Flying as secondary payloads on EM-1, 13 CubeSats will be located where on the SLS rocket? The Orion stage adapter? The launch vehicle stage adapter? Or the forward skirt? After the Orion spacecraft separates from the ICPS, the CubeSats will embark on their own deep space missions. But where will these little stowaways hitch their rides? The 13 small satellites will ride into deep space inside the Orion stage adapter, which will connect Orion to the ICPS. Each has a mission that can provide NASA with new key knowledge and test new technologies. CubeSats flown on the mission will perform in-space experiments and demonstrations that will advance the capabilities needed to take humans farther into space than ever before. There you go! Three questions all about how SLS will enable a new era of deep space exploration. You know, sometimes I amaze even myself. How did you do? Let us know in the comments and make sure to share with your friends. For more information about the Space Launch System, follow us on Twitter and Facebook and visit nasa.gov/SLS. Thanks for playing.